Alex, I know it was a tough night out there for you tonight, kind of fighting an uphill battle with Hayes and Connor Law out there. I know that you've been trying to get in touch with Dale. I mean, we all saw the footage at the end of the match at Super Gold. What's going on with the pillar?
I do not know, Spencer. I think that's what scares me the most. I went out there and got my absolute butt beat by Purple Haze, who is a phenomenal competitor, though their methods are not great. Same honor. Great, you know, great competitor. But when it comes to us, I cannot get into contact with Dale. I don't know what the state of the pillar is. I don't know what the state of my wrestling career looks like. But I have to.
Well, I mean, you guys are scheduled to compete at Off the Chain tag team match, right? You and Dale are supposed to be back at it, sort of the rebound against Property of Self.
Yeah.
Is that happening?
Oh, what's happening? Whether I'm in the ring alone, or Dale's in my corner, I will make it happen. Because we are the pillar. I am a pillar, and I have to stand strong. And whoever's behind me or in my corner will be there or won't be there.
Thanks for the time.
Wrestling 225 family, welcome to a new episode of Unleashed. I'm Spencer alongside Landon, and we are here at the Mike Zito Center in Plaquemine, Louisiana for Off the Chain.
That's right, 225 is back in Plaquemine. Come on, how excited are you?
It is such an exciting time for us here in Pro Wrestling 225. We've got an exciting venue tonight as well here at the Mike Zito Center, and a great night of action ahead on Unleashed tonight.
Hey, it feels really great in here. We got a little breeze going. What a night of action. Tonight is going to get unleashed because in our main event, we have Property of Self returning to Pro Wrestling 225 to take on the Pillar.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how the Pillar is their first time tagging together since they lost their tag team championships at Super Gold. But also in tonight's episode, cold-blooded Wes Warren goes one-on-one with a familiar face in 225, it's 12-gauge DJ Cyprian.
Man, high energy. 12-gauge always knows how to get the blood pumping in the crowd. This is going to be a fun one against Wes Warren.
But we're kicking things off tonight by letting the Mad Dog off the chain in singles action as he goes one-on-one with the Louisiana playboy, Tony Telesca.
Absolutely. We saw these two hammer it out in the Super Gold Rumble. What are they going to do tonight at Off the Chain?
That's how we're going to kick things off. But first, let's hear from a returning JTM who shocked everyone at his return in Albany just a week ago. What's he got to say tonight about Simon Phillips and Disobey?
Now that we're on the other side of 225 Mania, and I let some of the emotions wash out of me, it's been 7 long months. And I know I just said that at 225 Mania to Landon, all the mixed emotions I had that night. I need you to understand, Simon, that I didn't take 7 months off because you repped a chair across my back twice. I didn't take 7 months off because you tried to split my skull open with a chair. I didn't take 7 months off because you wrapped a chair around my neck and tried to break it. I took 7 months off because that night in September, when you stuck a knife in my back, I was waiting and watching. From the shadows, I saw the monster I've always known you to be come to the surface. The monster I watched not only win battles in the ring, but win battles outside of the ring your entire life. See, Simon, I'm not just coming back for my revenge. I'm coming back to prove that I'm better than the best, and that is exactly what you have become over the past 7 months. The toast of the Gulf Coast, the defiant king. All the people you've defeated in the ring, all over the Gulf Coast and in Pro Wrestling 225, all the people you faced and took to the limit. So Simon, pretty soon, very soon, you will be the first to bow down. Because like I told Landon at 225 Mania, every knee shall bow. Every tongue will confess that JTM is better than the best. JTM is the greatest.
Tony has entered the building. See what he's got in store here for Pro Wrestling 225 Unleashed presents Off the Chain. Off the Chain here, we have returned to Plaquemine, Louisiana for some hard-hitting action. It's gonna be one hell of a night tonight. See, we're right here in the Mike Zito Center in Plaquemine. It's gonna be edgy, it's gonna be dirty. It's gonna be a fun one, ladies and gentlemen. Oh. That out. I think the Mad Dog is gonna have a few words for Tony Telesca. But then again, Gil Gracie doesn't need to say anything. Talks with his fists. Yes. The Mad Dog is here at Off the Chain. And he is going to just walk all over Tony Telesca in this one, mark my words. Mad Dog is riled up. He's looking for a fight tonight. Tony Telesca. He's just asking for it.
What is this?
Are you serious? Oh yeah, tell DJ how to do his job. That makes sense. This thing is underway. We are kicking things off and off the chain here in Plaquemine. And look at this. Immediately, the Pro Wrestling 225 family excited to see the Mad Dog back in Plaquemine.
Well, if anyone is going to make things off the chain, it's got to be Gil Gracie,
it's gonna
right?
It's going to be the Mad Dog.
Let me show you how it's really done.
Oh, yeah. Are you just serious? Did you hear what he just said?
Yeah. Ooh, warmly received in Plaquemine. Yeah, that's Tony Telesca.
That's how it's done, bud.
Well, and Gracie's going to show him how it's done here in the corner now. Big chop. Welcome to 225, Tony Telesca.
Absolutely. Look, these two each had a really good showing in the Super Gold Rumble not too long ago, and here they are going one-on-one. Oh, Tony Telesca just takes it. Mad Dog tosses him to the corner, face bounces off that turnbuckle. Hard chop.
What do you think about this, Landon? Tony making his singles debut. Can you imagine a tougher competitor to debut against singles action here in 225 than the Mad Dog?
Tell you what, it's almost as if he's being punished, being asked to go one-on-one with the Mad Dog in your first singles match. I mean, we talked about it. The legendary history, of course, Gil Gracie with one of the most prolific title reigns in Pro Wrestling 225 history as we see that perfect big back body drop.
Absolutely. Gil Gracie absolutely on fire to kick things off tonight. And Tony Telesca, I would say wisely, stepping out of the ring, needing a little bit of a breather there from the Magic.
You're absolutely right. Tony Telesca going to have to hit the reset button right now.
I think
is he in trouble already?
Listen, Telesca said, let me show you how it's done. What he meant was, let me show you how I can get out of the ring, how I can take my time, how I can regroup, because Mad Dog's a little too much for me right now.
Yeah, well, Mad Dog's on the scent.
Uh-oh.
Tony's in trouble.
Very menacing, Mad Dog, just sort of at a methodical pace chasing after Telesca here.
Tell you what, there's not a very long list of people I would want chasing after me, but Gil Gracie's not on the list.
Certainly not. And Telesca, seemingly distracted by the 225 family here, almost got caught.
Take your eyes off the prize. Gil Gracie just about caught up.
I think our official DJ Petrie being a little lenient here with the count, but Telesca does get in to break it, and I think that was the plan the whole time, right?
Makes a lot of sense, but how much cardio did he waste running around the ring several times like that?
Well, Gracie's still in great shape, so if it was to try to wear out the Mad Dog, I don't know that was going to get the job done. A kick out at one, and look at that. Yeah, straight up to his feet. Gil Gracie, I think, just annoyed more than anything with the Louisiana Playboy.
Well, I think you're exactly right on that one. And Gil Gracie whips him in the corner. No, Tony turns things around. Look at that back elbow there in the corner.
Stomping Gil Gracie down to the mat there. Look at this, a boot straight into the throat there, using the full extent of his five count. You know, we were sort of mocking Tony a little bit in terms of like this being a really big challenge for opening match, but think about the upside, think about the ceiling. If Tony Telesca gets this win against the Mad Dog in his first singles match in 225, sky's the limit.
You're exactly right. Picture perfect suplex. Telesca got the win here, not with the cover like that. Look at this. Mad Dog gets the shoulder up. I mean,
yeah, you really can't be lenient in your, you know, sort of lackadaisical in your pin attempts on the Mad Dog. It's going to take everything you have. So not hooking the leg, not putting your whole body weight on top of the Mad Dog is going to be the difference between potentially winning or losing this match.
Yeah, I mean, just this is first impressions, right?
Sure.
I don't know what all he could do. Hard shoulder tackle here. But to me, it kind of seems like Tony Telesca, all bark and no bite here at Off the Chain.
Yeah, and we'll see if that remains to be true as he gets knocked down. Big sort of elbow there from Gil Gracie straight to the face of the Louisiana Playboy. Cover on Telesca now and a count of just one. but seems the advantage has gone to the Mad Dog. But as soon as I say that, it looked like maybe a rake of the eyes there in the attempt to get up there from Telesca has shifted sort of momentum and control back to Telesca just like that.
Spencer, I need to ask you, what does it take to be a Louisiana playboy? Like, what does that mean? Do you have like some kind of like special ID to get into a special club? Like, what is that?
Well, I think it's something that you and I probably would not know anything about. Oh my God! Drop kick to the back of the skull landed.
Trying to wear Gil Gracie down. That arm around the throat. DJ Petrie, perfect position. Make sure this thing doesn't creep over into a choke.
225 family trying to will the Mad Dog back to his feet, and they do. Trying to break free, is able to do that. Whips Telesca across. Big splash in the corner there. And we've seen this before. Follows it up with a bulldog there from the Mad Dog.
Lateral press and only a two.
Kick out there. But the last thing you want is for Gil Gracie to get warmed up.
And look at this. You've seen that look on the Mad Dog's face before. When Gil Gracie gets fired up, you're in trouble. Don't care who you are, Louisiana playboy or not.
But Telesca, very smart, was able to sort of go low to the midsection there and then bring Gracie back down to the mat. Hard to you know, really have offense when you're on your back. And I don't know, DJ Petrie needs to get there, our official. That was a little low to me, Landon.
It's the leg here, nonetheless, only a two count. You think Mustang was ever a Louisiana playboy?
Telesca back to his feet. Gil Gracie up against the ropes now. I think if you're Tony Telesca, things are going according to plan.
That's exactly right. I mean, you couldn't really ask for a much better showing. He's the former 225 champion, but you gotta keep eyes in the back of your head with Gil Gracie.
And a third time taking down Telesca.
But Spencer, I think you're exactly right. This thing has been back and forth. I mean, Tony came into this thing with a game plan. Is he going to be able to put away Gil Gracie, though?
Oh!
Are you kidding me?
What are you talking about? You didn't see that?
A low blow? Gil Gracie having none of it. Low blow or not. This thing is over. Tony Telesca clear as day with the low blow. Gil Gracie, obviously not the way Gracie wanted to win, but nonetheless, the winner here at Off the Chain in our opening match, Gil Gracie. Tony Telesca just couldn't get the job done, saw there was no way he was going to get the pin on Gil, and decided to take the coward's way out, Spencer.
Yeah, you know, we were talking about it. Everything was going according to plan, and I have to imagine, Landon, that that was part of the plan, too. If he was going to get in over his head, he wasn't going to take a loss to the Mad Dog, but, you know, he pissed Gil Gracie off, and he paid for it at the end. And like you said, Landon, the Mad Dog off the chain here tonight in Plaquemine.
Stella, let me explain something to you. I have a match against DJ Cyprian tonight. I do not need your help. You understand me? I need you to stay away. All right? You're getting on my nerves. All right? We can hash this out some other time, but now, tonight is not the night. All right? I got DJ Cyprian tonight, and I got Corey Constantine next weekend. I do not need to see you right now. I'm trying to get things back on track here. All right? Stay away. This Ginger Avengers thing has ran its course, and it's done. So forget about it, all right?
God.
Thank you.
Wess Warren is walking in to off the chain with a chip on his shoulder, no doubt. This man wants more than anything to be champion again here in Pro Wrestling 225, a former SEC champion. And man, it seems like he's had opportunity after opportunity lately to get up there. Of course, as we know, the man to score the first fall in that 60-minute Ironman match, and most recently scoring the win at 225 Mania alongside Stella Rin in that tag team match against the game team of Level X. But can he make it back to the title? Tonight, he's gonna have his hands full with a 12 gauge. DJ Cyprian is back in Pro Wrestling 225. Of course, last time we saw DJ over at Into the Hornet's Nest in Albany, he is here in Plaquemine tonight to make a statement win over Wess Warren. Incredible competition. This one's gonna be fun, ladies and gentlemen. Immediately, the fans behind DJ Cyprian.
No shocker there. I wouldn't say Wess Warren exactly somebody that our Pro Wrestling 225 family wants to get behind. Wess Warren immediately turning his back to DJ Cyprian. Maybe tells you a lot of what he thinks about DJ.
Yeah, I mean, this is sort of the mindset that we see Wess Warren in, right? Is it a confidence thing? Is he always overconfident? Is he looking past DJ here tonight? Let me tell you something. That would be a dangerous course of action. I mean, DJ Cyprian, former winner of the Super Gold Rumble.
You're absolutely right. The last time we saw DJ, he beat Brian Awesome into the Hornet's Nest last year. And listen, DJ looks incredible. He's in great ring shape. He's ready to go here. And the last thing that Wess Warren needs right now is to lose focus and then lose this match and sort of off-rail and derail all the momentum Wess Warren has.
That's exactly right. Wess Warren most recently getting that win, like I said, over Level X. I mean, he's getting all these opportunities to showcase what he can do. But eventually, he's gonna snap. I mean, we know how much of a loose cannon Wess Warren can be.
Well, let me ask you to that point, Landon, look at that takedown there.
Perfect toe hold.
Yeah, got DJ Cyprian right in the middle of the ring. Seems very focused now. But when it comes to this very loose cannon, what does that mean with Stella Rin and this sort of Ginger Avengers thing that he doesn't seem to be a fan of? But could she be sort of the thing that mellows him out? What do you think?
You know, that's really tough to call. I mean, you know, with Stella Rin, it does seem to have that effect on Wess Warren at some times. But again, Wess Warren, that's a tough nut to crack.
Absolutely. Wess Warren getting a little frustrated there by Cyprian getting the upper hand on the mat, creates some distance, and now looking to see maybe some, yep, got the wrist there of 12 gauge. Wess Warren regaining control here of the former Super Gold Rumble winner.
You know, both of these guys have a deep love for the sport of pro wrestling. They could go technical wrestling. DJ Cyprian, we know, could be a bit of a high flyer. Wess Warren, more of a brawler, keeping DJ down. And look at this chop.
Big striker. I mean, Wess Warren, definitely not a guy you'd want to get in there and just trade blows with. And look, going for that exploder, that suplex in the corner.
DJ did his homework.
Yep, able to battle out of it, it seems, trying to at least. Whips Warren across. This time, Warren, the one able to reverse their elbow straight to Cyprian.
Did he get it?
This time, oh, it works. Suplex into the turnbuckle.
Can't avoid it all day. Wess Warren gets that explosive offense in. keeping DJ down to the mat. Rolls him over, lateral press, and only a two. Wes Warren, we know, has a really big contest coming up at Movement 6 against none other than Corey Constantine, Spencer.
Yeah, absolutely. That is going to be a huge, huge match, sort of vying for who is next in line for a championship opportunity. And appropriately enough, the special guest referee for that match, Landon, Russian Destruction, Vladimir Koloff.
Our double champ, Vladdy Koloff.
Big chop from Cyprian in the corner.
In the stripes at Movement 6. I cannot wait for that one. Look at that snap suplex. Lightning quick from DJ. Floats over, only a two. Oh, is that a one count? Gets the shoulder up real quick. But nonetheless, DJ Cyprian really quickly coming back. And that's the thing about DJ. Never, ever count this man out.
Going for another suplex. Warren able to sort of keep that weight advantage. And look at that straight drop, Cyprian over the top rope.
Good Lord.
Absolutely nasty, and a big knee.
Right to the temple of Cyprian.
Could be the beginning of the end for 12 gauge. Absolutely cold-blooded stuff from Warren. But Cyprian is able to kick out there.
Stays in it. Lot of fight in DJ Cyprian, man. This is a man that is always looking forward. He's always looking for his next opportunity and takes absolutely nothing for granted. Hard shot right there to Wes Warren.
Yeah, I think he got just enough of him to get Warren off of his feet. And now looking for back suplex.
Oh,
almost a delayed back suplex there.
Did you see the height on that?
Showing strength of his own. Cover. And a two on Wes Warren. If you like this action on Pro Wrestling 225 Unleashed, make sure you hit that subscribe button and stay ready for every single Friday with new episodes on Pro Wrestling 225 Unleashed.
And hey, comment while you're there. Let us know who's your favorite star that you see on 225 Unleashed.
Uh-oh, picking up the pace. Turns around.
Took his head off with that hard clothesline and only a two.
I think he learned a little bit of that from his brief time as part of Cold War. Almost a sickle there from Warren.
Wasn't quite as perfectly applied as the Koloff sickle,
what?
But nonetheless.
Now Wes Warren has DJ Cyprian exactly where he wants him, down in the center of the ring.
Looks like DJ's trying to roll forward to use as much weight as he can to get closer to the rope and roll Wes off. But he's able to stand up even better, creates that separation.
Bounces off, comes back.
Ooh, and almost not able to jump up in time and gets tripped up there.
Oh, we've seen this from Warren before. Watch out, DJ. Oh.
Absolutely draped over that rope.
Wes Warren has used the ropes in this match as almost a tag team partner, dealing extra damage to DJ several times throughout this match. We haven't seen Warren up on the top rope very often. What's he got in mind here?
Dangerous, dangerous territory. What a drop kick. Diving down, hooks the leg. Only a two that time, but let me tell you something. There's not a lot of hitch in the giddy up of DJ Cyprian right now.
Warren gets him back to his feet, but Snapmare takes him down, and look at this. Yep, submission again, right back in the ring. This has been Warren's game plan. Even though he's able to execute the drop kick off the top rope and things like that, this is what he prefers. Slow and steady, brutal, just dealing damage, hurting his opponent. And that's what's happening right now to DJ Cyprian in the center of the ring.
This is the Achilles heel of DJ Cyprian. Can Wes Warren keep him down, keep him grounded, clip the wings? DJ trying to find that wrist control again.
Time and time again, Cyprian has been able to sort of counter that leverage advantage, get back to his feet.
Wes Warren had it sniffed out on that occasion, though. Looks like a suplex here from Wes Warren. Crashes down to the ring.
Warren and Cyprian, really good stuff here. It's been kind of a lot of Warren here in the first half of this matchup here. He goes for it again.
Nobody home. Wes.
DJ learned his lesson from the first time around.
That's right. DJ, really smart, making the adjustments, learning on his feet. Look at this. Oh, how about that? Talk about using the ropes to your advantage. Now DJ. What's he got here? Up and over for the suplex. Floats over.
Is Cyprian going to get the win? Not quite. Kick out at two there from Warren, but what a match here at Off the Chain.
Competitive back and forth. I don't know that Wes Warren was expecting this much fight out of 12 gauge.
Whips him into the turnbuckle.
Hits the corner hard there.
Turns him around. What's Cyprian got in mind?
Pushes him off. Whoa. Look at this! Neck breaker from a grounded Wes Warren there. His neck just hit really hard. Kind of an awkward angle on that one.
Right. And Cyprian now the one taking it to this guy potentially on that middle rope.
Gotta watch Cyprian. Goes over. No, gets caught. The worst possible scenario. There it is. That is the cold-blooded driver. Wes Warren continues his momentum and carries it going forward into movement six, where he's got Corey Constantine waiting. But what a match.
Highly competitive, what we come to expect from DJ Cyprian and of course from Wes Warren. You know, ever since he lost the SEC championship to Mustang Mike, it's been a sort of a story of what ifs and almosts for Wes Warren, but it's time to start thinking that maybe it's time for the cold-blooded Warren to get his next opportunity.
Hey, dude, what are we, you weren't there last week, I tried calling you, texting you, nothing. What is going on?
No.
It's my turn to talk now. So, I've been here, nothing but here for you. Nothing but here for you. I was your caddy. I was your right-hand man. And sure, we fought, but I was here for you. I was trying to tell you a motive. I was trying to help you out. Trying to teach you how to be a good person. And then that happened. Sure, it took a golf club to the back, but now we're here. You called me again to face Simon and disobey. And look at where we're at. We're here. And then you take one loss and you can just leave? No. We're not doing this whole leave thing. I made a promise to you, so we're gonna go out there, we're gonna go fight the best fight that we can give, and then we're gonna go take our titles back, yeah?
Sure, let's go do our thing.
Nastico in the house. And there they are.
Introducing first, being a puppet to the ring by the best manager, Nastico. Weighing in at a combined weight of none of your business. From Dallas, Texas, they are Levi Lucas and the Black Taylor Swift.
Did I hear that right?
Future tag champs here at Pro Wrestling 225.
Nonetheless, TJ Slater, Levi Lucas in the house. Property of Self is back in Pro Wrestling 225, one of the hottest teams in the South. Getting up close and personal with the 225 family here. Nastico here to keep everything calm, everything. Oh, Nastico looking to get involved. Property of Self, an incredibly talented tag team. And going to be a really interesting test for the Pillar here tonight, as we know the history there with everything that's been going on with the Pillar, from what we saw at Super Gold losing the tag titles, for Property of Self coming in here to try and take over 225. What a statement win they could make here tonight, pinning the former tag teams. And they're together. There was a lot of questions going into this. Was Dale Springs going to be here? And you could tell his demeanor, you know, maybe not like we usually, like we're used to seeing Dale Springs, but the Pillar, nonetheless, in this thing, together again, here at Off the Chain.
But you can tell things are a little bit off with Dale Springs and Alex Braddock here, right? Alex Braddock seems very ready, very game, and almost like he's having to pull Dale Springs along.
It looks like Dale Springs being consoled a little bit by some folks in the 225 family, people very familiar with what happened at Super Gold. But look,
listen, they're going to touch tips. It's all right. We're going to touch tips right now. Everything's going to be fine. Everything's going to be fine. Here we go. Dale Springs, Alex Braddock ready to touch tips. Here we go.
The good old days, come on. Maybe not.
Huh?
Are they on the same page or not? Man, I was excited. I really thought the Pillar was back together. I mean,
well, sometimes what you need is to work it out together as a team, right?
What better way to do it
than against this Property of Self, one of the best tag teams in Texas here in 225 now. We've seen them before. We know how good they are. The last time we saw them, they went up against the Overboys and almost got the job done. And we know the Overboys, if I may say, the Pillar at times of the tag team division here in Pro Wrestling 225. And now they're here to test themselves against the Pillar, Alex Braddock and Dale Springs. And I think we're going to learn a lot about both of these teams in this matchup tonight.
You're absolutely right. Property of Self, look, they've said it multiple times. They're champions in Texas. They want to be champions right here in 225. And, man, this is the way to do it, right? Get your win over a former tag team champion. Work
Absolutely.
Yourself up the ladder.
Right, you got to think we're sort of battling it out here to see who could be next in line to challenge Purple Haze and Hunter Law, the tag team champions.
Got Levi Lucas in there. Let's kick things off with Dale Springs. A little bit of a test of strength here. Dale Springs got a lot of power in that man.
And look at this. Smart there from Dale Springs.
Exactly right. Look at that.
Kind of vicious there. Working on the joints and the fingers of
Levi
Lucas.
Ooh,
we've seen this before. Going to make him touch tips.
Nope.
Again. Dale Springs pulls him away. What is that about?
Dale Springs just hasn't been quite the same since losing the tag team championships. In that really, I mean, it was an unpredictable moment. I mean, Super Gold, they laid out the open challenge, and, you know, he just couldn't get the job done, and it's really eating this man alive.
I will tell you, Nastico, the best manager, right, trying to regroup here with Property of Self, trying to call for a timeout, he didn't even want our camera people in on the strategy session there. So we'll see what this sort of, what Nastico did. Was that enough to refocus Levi Lucas here? As he gets back in the ring, collar and elbow tie up with Dale Springs, able to push Springs back into the turnbuckle there. Official DJ Petrie.
Dale with perfect defense right there. You saw he got the forearm right in the face of Lucas. Gets that separation, and look at that. That's exactly right. And you see Dale using his hips, using all that weight, keeping Lucas down onto the mat. That man knows what he's doing, but wait a minute, Lucas finds the escape.
Look at this. Springs able to turn it around
What a great back and forth mat wrestling between these two.
Stretching Lucas out. Lucas needs a tag to Slater bad here.
Dale's got those legs trapped. Ooh. Oh my God, just absolutely crushes the elbow there. And okay, we've got a tag. In comes Alex Braddock.
I wouldn't say the most energetic of tags. You can tell still something very, very off between Braddock and Springs now. And I'm not sure that Braddock was really loving the tactics that Springs had in there with Lucas, but what a move there, up and over with the leg to the back. Fisherman suplex with the bridge. Can he get both shoulders down? Not quite, but the damage done. Very strong work there from Alex Braddock.
More damage being done to the back of Lucas here. Okay, got a little bit of a tag. Is that a legal tag? I barely touched him.
Braddock was trying to do some sort of tag team work there. Springs not interested.
Just low energy from Dale Springs. So unlike him.
They're taking a lot of time trying to figure this whole thing out.
Look, Lucas.
But Springs still able to reverse that clothesline attempt from Lucas. Oh!
All right. Dale Springs got the tips up. Here comes TJ. Oh my God!
Over the knee!
Hooks the leg!
Dale Springs seems content to do it all on his own right now, Landon.
You know what? I don't know if maybe that's where his headspace is. Is he blaming Alex Braddock maybe for their loss? Feels like he needs to stay in there and do as much damage as he can.
But Braddock in. Oh, reversal.
Oh no! The pillar crashing into each other here. We saw, oh my God, what a backdrop. I mean, we saw that their heads just absolutely crushed.
And now a tag to TJ Slater. And I think the momentum has shifted, firmly in control of Property of Self now.
Double underhooks here, up and what a slam just launches Alex Braddock across the ring.
But a very confident, very cocky cover there. Not gonna get the job done on Alex Braddock.
TJ with a hard forearm. Braddock in no man's land there.
Yeah, Braddock absolutely in the wrong corner. Oh, quite here.
Oh my God! Not the nipple twister!
Adding insult to injury to the storyteller there.
Let me get this right. This man's the Black Taylor Swift.
That is true. A tortured poet in his own right.
I see.
Yeah. Lucas now, look at that, breaking the back.
But all the while, still has that front face lock locked in.
Yeah, and you can tell he got off. Even closer to Dale Springs there, almost taunting Braddock's tag team partner. And it might come back to haunt him.
Look at this, Northern Lights finds the escape, hooks the leg.
And a kick out at two, but great work there from Braddock to change things around on Levi Lucas. Can he get to Springs and make a tag?
Alex Braddock trying to roll Levi over to his corner, but needs to do a little bit more damage first. Looks like trying to go back to that fisherman.
But Lucas fights out of it, and a big swinging neck breaker there.
Hard neck breaker, and Levi, look at the confidence from Property of Self in this one. I mean, look, that's one of the keys that you need to beat a team like the Pillar.
They know they're good, right? They know they're confident. They've been in Texas. They've been tearing it up in Texas. They know they can do it. They're just trying to prove themselves now here in Pro Wrestling 225. And so far, it's going their way. Alex Braddock needs, he's been in that ring a long time, he needs a tag to Springs.
These frequent tags here from Property Itself, Lucas back in, and again, a taunt over to Dale Springs. Oh, tandem offense. Hard shot there to Alex Braddock. Braddock's in trouble here.
You can tell Property Yourself have been teaming for way longer than a fortnight. The cover, no, just a two count there. Levi Lucas doesn't exactly hook the leg, but still firmly in control of the storyteller.
Keeping Alex Braddock, you notice he's got almost got him face first right there, just locked in. Cutting off the breath
And I think this is what Property of Self loves about, like, that's why this team works, right? Levi Lucas, a mouthpiece, absolutely talking trash the whole time he's got Alex Braddock here on the mat. And you see Nastico and TJ Slater, they're eating it up on the outside. Oh! Just when Braddock was going to fight back into this, uses the hair to slam him back down on the mat. And then you can take your time. Tag in Slater. Continue the damage, continue the offense.
Property of Self is getting in the zone. They feel like they got this match on lock, but can they wrap it up? Can they finish it?
Slater leapfrogs over just for Braddock to run into a drop kick from Levi Lucas.
TJ.
And again, this, oh, using the ropes there.
Yeah, not necessarily looking to get the pin on that one, I don't think. Looking to do just even more damage, but I mean, a little bit lackadaisical, right? Big slam here from TJ. Looks like, what is that?
Almost toying with Alex Braddock.
I think these guys got a little bit of overconfidence peeking this ugly head in here. Yes, you notice that your opponents are not on the same page, but you can't let Alex Braddock gain the momentum, and he doesn't.
Spring's trying to get a tag there. He's trying to will his tag team partner to his corner.
Alex is in trouble here.
But again, in the wrong corner. Again, a tag. Lucas now the legal man for Property of Self.
Dale Springs might have to think about just inserting himself in here at some point.
Uh-oh.
Wait, lands on his feet. No.
Don't do it. Big German sends Braddock all the way across the ring on his neck.
Lands right on the back of the neck.
This might be it, but TJ Slater not the legal man.
And Lucas not really interested in getting the win here. I think you're right, Spencer. It's almost as if they're toying with the former champions in this match. I mean, how confident can you be? Oh my God, did you hear that?
Takes Springs out. Now Braddock doesn't have a partner to tag on the outside.
Springs should have thought about inserting himself a little bit earlier. Now he may have been just eliminated from this contest. This thing could be over in a matter of moments.
Braddock ducks under though, wait for it. Drop kick takes Levi Lucas down. Is that the reset that Alex Braddock needs?
Perfect opportunity for the storyteller to get to his corner. And Dale Springs makes it up just in time. Could this be it? Dale Springs can get back into this match.
Tag to Slater.
What? The hell was that?
Well, that's a tag.
You're supposed to be better.
Well deserved, if you ask me. Alex Braddock with a slap across the face. Dale Springs, I believe, is the legal man right now.
Not sure if our official DJ Petrie's counting that as a tag. But the focus for Property of Self continues to be on Alex Braddock.
Well, what's the deal? What's the deal here? Alex Braddock needed a tag desperately.
Springs in. How about that?
Hard shot here. Dale Springs, that slap might have been exactly what Dale Springs needed to come alive in this one. Maybe Alex Braddock knew exactly what he was doing. Wait a minute. I got you. Now this is the pillar that I know.
Double face wash, running boots to both members of Property of Self. And Landon, I think you may have been right. Braddock and Springs seem to be on the same page now.
Okay.
The pillar looking to finish the job, but Nastico holding on to Braddock.
Oh, no. Dale Springs sent crashing into Alex Braddock. Pillar could be in trouble here. Property of Self setting it up. Repo driver.
TJ Slater rolls Dale Springs over.
Just like that, man, just when you thought the Pillar was getting that momentum back, Dale Springs back on the same page with Alex Braddock, and everything falls apart. Little bit, just a slight miscommunication, could have happened to anybody, but Property of Self, a game team, able to take advantage, able to score a huge win here in Pro Wrestling 225. And obviously the frustration showing from Alex Braddock. Not what they needed to move forward as a team together. I mean,
they just beat the Pillar?
I don't know. Property of Self, an incredibly impressive showing here at Off the Chain. Hats off to him. Fantastic team. Just seems like the Pillar needed this win. Didn't get it.
Property of Self, the new Pillar is a Pro Wrestling 225.
You know, Dale Springs has a lot on his mind going in to this match, and now, you know, looking forward, he has an incredibly important match at Movement 6 for the Movement Championship against Hunter Law, the very man that took away the tag team championships from the Pillar. Don't know maybe how much of that match has been weighing on his mind. Dale Springs picking up Alex Braddock here. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
You want to be here for me? Freaking be here for me.
That's what you want to see. That's right. That is the Pillar. These two have gone to war together. Highs and lows. All right. We're going to get it? We're going to get it? Ladies and gentlemen. Touch tips! Hear it off the chain. Win, lose, or draw, the Pillar stands strong here in Pro Wrestling 225.